Low tray. That appears to be some lichen on the bark of this tree. If I was a caribou, I could probably eat it. But I'm not a caribou, so I can't eat it. Let's talk about field work. It's what geographers typically do on their typical day, when they're on their typical job of the day, is wearing typical hats and probably lab coats. Though they probably don't wear lab coats. I'm not wearing a lab coat right now, so I'm not really doing much. Lab coats are meant for protection. I am very well protected out here. With air. Air is very protecting. Human geography is when we see how people make places. Give me a second. Those things are bad things, and we're going to need to destroy them. Be done. You see, while I was out here doing my field work, I came across a couple of these things. They're like dogs, and they like to eat trees. That's how they feast, to eat trees, but because they're blind, they can't tell the difference between people and trees. Which is why this dog was trying to eat me instead of the tree. Anyways, this is a perfect time to explain human geography again. Thus answering one of our key questions, what is human geography? How people react to a certain stimulus. Such as the wolves. Clearly, they would react in anger and hatred and fire flaming arrows at their bodies in violence. Don't do that at home. It's very dangerous to fire arrows because they're arrows and arrows are dangerous. Now, we're always looking for food, and when we can't get the hard food, we have to get the easy food. I'm sorry you had to see that, but I was really hungry, and I really needed some food. Let's see here, there is an abandoned wagon here. Speaking of which, let's talk about globalization. Globalization, when one tries to increase their interactions with other people, disregarding the borders and heightening their interdependence while deepening their relationships with other people. That's probably what that guy was doing over there. He was probably trying to, what's in here? He's trying to sell his invisible cabbage to other people in other places. So then he could, like, get into a deep relationship with the one farmer lady. And, yeah, deepen their relationship with that. While screwing over the borders because there are no borders here. The only borders here are, hatred. Hatred is the only border. That is a very bright sky. Let's keep going. Now, while we're on this path, let's go ahead and talk about physical geography. Physical geography. It's the study of physical phenomena on Earth. Look at this butterfly. I heard something very disturbing, and I don't know what it is, and I don't know where it is. We're gonna crouch and hide until something finds us, because that was a really scary noise. Let's look at this here. This phenomena right here. Not the root. Don't look at the root. Something saves me. Oh god, no, not you. Not see how violent they are. See how they want to chop on me. I mean, and there's some suspicious looking things over there. I guess we should move on to the cultural part of this area. Culture. The imprint of human activity upon the land. Clearly, there was some activity on the land here. As you can see, a very person with OCD was here. And, I don't know, I guess they wanted to stand here, and everywhere they looked, There would be a gate, and it would be of equal distance, and they would all look the same. Except that one. That one's not cool enough. Then they would look at the sky and say, I don't know what they would say. They would probably say this. And then it would glow blue. And they would be like, yeah, this is awesome. And that is how they would call the gods and tell them that their life sucks. So let's go ahead and talk about this map. It's a map of the Hoenn region. If you don't know where that is, then that's too bad for you, and please ignore the beeps that are going on behind me. So, maps. This is a map. Maps can be used to wage war, solve medical problems, create propaganda, locate places, warn people of almost all of those things. For example, if I wanted to wage war here, I could just, circle wherever the heck I live. I live somewhere around here in this volcano. Oh, I can't see that at all. I'll use this. I live somewhere around here. In New Zealand. Yes. If I wanted to wage war, say, on this area here, all I would have to do is get a navy. And then flank them from this side, and also from this side. But also, I could get a navy through here, onto that island, and then move to more islands, and then move to that mountain over there. After I cut down all these trees. And by that point, I would be in this mountain. And when I'm at this mountain, I can take this path here, and then take them from here. And then this city will be mine! That is how we can use this stuff to wage war. Now I'm going to need to delete all of this. Now, what about medical geography? We can solve medical problems with maps, so let's just try to solve something here. After I pick a color, I'm going to pick orange. Medical geography. Distribution of disease. Such as the mapping of cholera that we all know and love, but I don't have that with me, and I don't really want to use it. I'm going to use purple. Should be easily seen. Yep, that's easily seen. Okay. So, let's see here. What if there was an orange-colored disease that was waterborne? It was created right here. A waterborne disease. Now, since it's just at a very small place, surely there's like no area, no place that would want to go there. But there's this small, tiny little village right here, and it'll get infected with this disease. And there's also this pathway here that's commonly tread by common people who throw balls at people, and also little critters. They'll want to go to this major city, should they be coming from the mountain, because when you're in the mountain, you usually want to flee. You'll either go this way, which takes you to possible doom, because it's a dead end, or you'll go this way, which will take you onto this commonly tread path, into this city of safety, and if you don't think that's safe enough, you can go along this bridge here, and into this city here. And if you still don't think that's safe enough, you can take this boat here, and sail all the way to Antarctica, which is way down there. Even so, if it did start here, then the disease would most likely infect these people. And then since they're fleeing through here, it'll infect this city too. And because it's spread by water, eventually all these border cities will be infected by this disease. And this and this and that tower thing there. And don't forget that little house on that one island. The only place that's safe is, well, I guess it would have to be here, considering that there's no water nearby. They would have to import that water. And who drinks imported water? No one does that nowadays. That's freaking ridiculous. They get their water from boiled lava. And from that, clean water, diseaseless. Let's talk about environmental determinism. Environmental determinism is when the environment determines your fate. Your fate, which you live in, what you do, and how you do it. If you have nothing, then the environment has... Okay, that wasn't meant to happen. Just, give me a sec. Alright, anyways. If you have nothing, then you can do nothing about the environment. And the environment will just do all kinds of crap to you. And you'll be very unhappy. You'll have to hide under this tree for shade, under the rain or something, when it's raining sunshine. Because when you're in the light, you sparkle. Because you're a vampire. Or you burn, or whatever vampires do. I don't know. Nowadays, it's kind of blurry what they do. But however, if you do manage to get tools, you can really live without trees. You can make your own little houses here. Give yourself a sense of place and a sense of home. Even build yourself a giant stone fortress. This is actually a church, but we're gonna call it a fortress anyways. And even bring water to you. And bathe your own chickens. That is possibilism. Possibilism when you can do whatever the screw you want with the environment. You decide the fate of the environment. And not vice versa. These look like carrots. Interesting. Okay, anyways, what is it doing? Let's look at this little house. This is a pretty cheap replica of where I live. So, yeah. A sense of place is a sense of home. Ignore that over there, it's completely useless. It's just a water pipe that does absolutely nothing. Home. What is home? Home is when you infuse the great feeling of a place into one single area. That's what this would be. That's what this cheap crap of a home is. Considering this is my home, well, this is really what I would like to do with it. This is a laser designator. We're going to explore how fun this is going to be. Home. What is home? Can I really call this a home if I'm not happy here? No. I can't. I don't need to call this a home. My home is elsewhere. The easy food.